Good morning. Welcome again to Matt Lachey, and I want to thank my staff for helping bring this about. Today we're going to count our blessings. Let's bow our heads. We thank you, Lord, for all the blessings you give us every day. And we especially thank you for sending your son. We don't want to forget that. And many of us are in the middle of stuff. We see all kinds of bad things going on, but without your blessings, we wouldn't be able to exist day by day. And that's what we're going to do, is go over your blessings. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. There's all kinds of things that God does for us every day. You know, we have the sun. It gives us the heat and the light, the time of day, seasons, even gravity. You know, the face of the sun, if you think about it, if you look, for instance, at the earth and the moon, the moon is set in its orbit around the earth. It's locked, you know, so we only see one side of the moon as it goes around. We see the same side. You've heard the phrase, the dark side of the moon. Well, there is a dark side, a side we never see. Only a few astronauts have seen and been on the other side of the moon. If the earth was locked in its position to the sun, like the moon is to the earth, we wouldn't have day and night. We wouldn't have seasons. We would, one side of the earth would be a burnt out cinder. The other side would be an ice cube. You know, if the earth went around the sun with just one face, you know, facing the sun all the time, it'd be a problem. Big problem. We couldn't exist. We have crops growing, we have food, we have water, we have rain. I don't know if you remember in the Old Testament when the children of Israel were out in the wilderness, God fed them with manna from heaven. It was called angel's food. And it would come down every morning. It would feed them. And I was reading this one time, and I thought to myself, Lord, why don't you just send some manna? You know, that would impress everybody, and everyone would believe in you, you know, if you send a miracle like that. Later that day, I happened to be outside, and a thunderstorm came up and started pouring rain. And I thought to myself, what is the difference between rain and manna? I mean, if we don't get the rain, we're not going to live. We're not going to have life. We're not going to have crops. We're not going to have, you know, water to drink. Rain is a miracle just like manna. We have the atmosphere, oxygen, just enough oxygen in the atmosphere. There's like 20 to 25% of the atmosphere is oxygen. And we have lungs that bring in the atmosphere and extract from the atmosphere oxygen, dispenses it into our body. These are all blessings from God. Now, we are told by evolutionists, all this happened by chance. All this just kind of came about. There's nothing behind it, you know, designing it, watching over it, making it happen. We have a body to live in. We have ears that detect sound waves, and we can understand speech through our ears, which sends messages to our mind. We have eyes that perceive light. Mouth, nose, arms, legs, fingers, brains, intellect, understanding, technology, science, engineering, it's all endless. You know, and the science and technology that we have today is dwarfs anything that anybody has had before us. Any rich person, any royalty that's lived the generations before our generations, they don't have the things we have. You know, we're living in a time of blessing unheard of. But the greatest blessing of all is Jesus dying for us. Without his death, we would have no hope for the future. Jesus dying on the cross, here's something interesting. He answers all the tough questions. You know, we all always have, every one of us, sometime or the other, we say, God, why did you let that happen? If you are a God of love, you wouldn't do X, Y, Z. You know, you wouldn't let this happen. But if you look very carefully at Jesus on the cross, that God would love us so much that he would take all this garbage on himself for us, it broadcasts that God is a God of love. Here's a verse. When Christ died for the ungodly, which is all of us, this one righteous act resulted in justification and life for all people. In other words, justice will be served. You know, we may think, well, this person shouldn't have done this to me, or this person shouldn't have done that. You know, where's the justice, you know, and we demand justice. Well, it will be served. It happened on the cross, you know, and Jesus will bring this about when he comes. It's through God being beaten and tortured and crucified for us that not only do we have salvation available to us, but there's justice. This is a blessing that surpasses all others. But think of what is being taught to us and being taught to our children in the schools. We're being taught that we're descended from apes and fish, that some type of Big Bang took place and brought forth all this into existence. Big Bangs or explosions don't create, they destroy. We dropped the bomb on Hiroshima not to create a city, but to destroy it, to end World War II. You can't show me any explosion anywhere that brings forth something. You know, to think of the theory of evolution in its purest form is like a tornado going through a junkyard and leaving behind a library or leaving behind a Boeing 747. It doesn't work that way. The incredible design in the universe demands a designer. It proclaims the existence of God. Think of this. These are a couple of verses from the Old Testament. The heavens are telling of the glory of God, and the firmament shows his handiwork. Day unto day pours forth speech. Night unto night reveals knowledge. So that which is known about God is evident to all, for God made it evident to them. For since the creation of the world, his invisible attributes, his eternal power and divine nature have been clearly seen, being understood through what has been made, so that we all are without excuse. All these blessings in nature and technology and expertise, all these are blessings from God, have been given to us. What Jesus did on the cross for us is the greatest blessing of all. And I encourage you to read the Gospels if you haven't. Read Matthew, Mark, Luke, or John. Or if you don't have time to read or don't want to read the whole thing, just read the last couple of chapters of one of them. You'll see that the cross is a divine thing. It's not something we would come up with. What Jesus did on the cross is greatest. Count your many blessings.
Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your blessings, see what God has.